Well, hello there, everybody. It is Blake. Welcome back to another super exciting, spectacular, fun Halloween themed video. If you guys came here because of the title of this video and you're not already subscribed, first things first, you guys, make sure you click on that subscribe button wherever it is around me. And also don't forget to hit that notification bell as well to be notified every time that I upload a brand new video here on YouTube, which I know is currently far and few between, but I have lots of plans for fun, spooky Halloween themed content coming to my channel here. So make sure that you guys are subscribed so you can see whenever I upload those fun videos that we all wait for all year long. And if you guys are just returning subscribers of mine and you came to see how things are going here, how are you doing, you guys? Let me know how you are by leaving a comment down in the comment section below, and we can chat down there about all things spooky, fun, Halloween-y, all the things we know and love so much. It's good to see you guys again, so thank you so much for returning. So yes, the title of this video, you guys, I went shopping down in the States. Yes, we went to America, one of my favorite places to visit because they have all the exciting things we don't have up here in Canada. If you guys don't know, I live in Vancouver, Canada, just above the border. It's like 30 minutes from where I live. And before the pandemic, pre-pandemic, we did used to go down quite often to go shopping to Bellingham, Bellisphere Mall. We went down to Seattle a couple times as well. And then the pandemic hit and obviously put everything on pause for the entire world. But now that the borders have reopened and they're a lot less strict with their guidelines and everything, we were able to head down more often. And what better time to head down to the States and go shopping than the spooky months, you guys? Yes. Officially, things start rolling out kind of like end of July, early August for all the Halloween stuff that we love. And here we are smack dab in the middle of September now, and we hit up all the stores in the States that we love. So we went down to the States yesterday and it was such a good time. We originally planned to go on September 30th with a few friends. And then one of my friends texted me and was like, what are you doing on Saturday? Do you want to go to the States? And I was like, yes, please. So we went and got our like pre-Halloween shopping trip out of the way, but we're still going on the 30th as well. So we were able to like look at a lot of things in stores, get some ideas of things that we wanted, buy a heck of a lot of stuff that I didn't know that I needed or wanted, and we still get to go down again in a couple weeks and enjoy all the fun experience all over again. So this haul that I'm sharing with you guys today is all the stuff that I purchased while I was in the States yesterday. Like I said, we went down to Bellingham, so there's Bellisphere Mall with a Target, there's a Walmart nearby there. We went to like Ross, TJ Maxx, Marshall's, Home Goods, lots of really, really good stores that have really, really good Halloween stuff. And that's what this haul is gonna be all about. So make sure that you guys are comfortable, get a nice cup of tea or cider, whatever you wanna get, and sit down for a fun, spooky Halloween haul. There isn't gonna be any particular order for the things that I'm showing you guys. I'm gonna do my best to try and remember like what things I got from what stores and a price point, and I'm gonna try and do it in order to the best of my ability. Nothing is better than anything else. Obviously, I have some things that I like really, really love, which I will show you guys, but nothing is like amazing that I'm starting off with. It's just kind of like in order of where we went shopping. And I also did film a whole like day vlog for the trip when we went down. So if that's not already up on YouTube by this point when you're watching this, it will be coming soon. Or if that is already up on YouTube, I'll link it down in the more info box down below and you guys can go check out the America Halloween hunt shopping vlog trip, whatever it's gonna be called, down there in the more info box, and you guys can check that out and let me know what your guys' thoughts are and come along on a fun shopping trip to the States with us. So without further ado, enough jibber jabbering, let's get right into it and start off with the first store that we went to. And I brought my own reusable bags, so I'm not gonna have any like bags from the stores. So just know that I was at those stores. This bag of Luca is from Dollar Tree. Dollar Tree was the first store that we hit up. As soon as we got across the border, we were like, let's go to Dollar Tree and see what fun stuff we can find there, if they have any goods. And we did. We found some cute things. I mostly got like Halloween candies that we don't have up here in Canada, but they're fun nonetheless. So first thing here is pumpkin spice moon pies. I don't actually know if I've ever had moon pies before, but pumpkin spice really got me, so I figured I had to try them. Next up is these Sour Patch Kids zombies. I don't think there's anything really zombie about them. I think they're just like Halloween colors, but they got me and I had to get them, so it worked out. Next here is these Halloween Sour Dudes blueberry sour straws. Never had those, but again, they sound great. Next up here is the Kool-Aid Goulade popping candies, Scary Berry. Didn't even know that Kool-Aid made like Pop Rocks, but I got them, so now I can try them out. Then we have the Warheads Sour Taffy here, which sounds really interesting as well. Love me some Warheads. Really, really sour. Then there's the Nerds Candy Corn, which seems super unique. It's like a hard candy outside, but like a soft, chewy center, which is interesting, so I'll have to try those. Then I got some Scooby-Doo graham crackers. I love these so much. We don't have those up here in Canada, which is so strange because it's literally just a graham cracker cookie. Like, why not? But oh well. Then I got some of this Brock's candy corn. We do carry candy corn up here in Canada, but not this brand. And this brand just, I feel like they do it best. I don't know, something about it. Next up, I have some boxes of lemon heads. we don't actually sell lemon heads up here in Canada. They sell them at some like boutique and specialty stores, but they're like $5 a box or like a dollar down in the States. So why not get them in the States? And then the last few things that I have inside this bag are just some makeup things for like Halloween costumes and stuff. There's some pairs of false lashes. I got this black eyeliner. It's like the Halloween collection. This is darkness eyeliner. And then I also got this lip liner called Zombie, which is a black lip liner. And then this red Vampire Kiss lip liner as well. And of course, all these things are like $1, $1.25 at Dollar Tree. So can't go wrong with that. And that's everything that I got at Dollar Tree. So not a bad start to the day and not a bad start to the haul. So let's continue on. I'm going to try a piece of the Nerds candy corn. Oh my goodness. It's very sour. I like it though. I don't know if that was that a flavor? Orange shell with cherry watermelon inside, I think was the one that I had. I don't know, it's good and sweet, so I like that. Next up here, we went to, what was it called? TJ Maxx. Now, gotta swallow the candy. I, like, typically all year round, I will shop at the ones that are comparable to the stores down in the States. So we have, like, Winners, HomeSense up here in Canada. We do have Marshalls up here as well. And I do shop at those ones all year round, but mostly at, like, the Halloween time is when I go there because they always have the best Halloween decorations. But whenever we go down to the States, we don't usually go there throughout the rest of the year. But at Halloween time, you guys, they turn it out. I remember when Brandon and I went to the States back in July, and it was like July 22nd, I think, or something like that. And the whole store of Home Goods was just filled. Every single end cap, every single aisle was like all Halloween. So the States does it right with their Halloween decorations, and they get so many more options and brands than what we get up here in Canada, which is so like mind-boggling because it's like it all has to be shipped to the States anyways. Why would they not just ship it up here? Like, what's the difference, really? I don't know why. They get so many cooler things than what we get up here. And it's like, it's sad. Because, I mean, obviously, I'm lucky enough that I'm able to travel down across the border. And now that we're post-pandemic, it's easier because we don't have, the, like I said, the restrictions or things like that anymore. But for anyone else that doesn't live close to a border, it's like, I mean, I want to say unfair, but that sounds so privileged to say. But you know what I mean? It's like, it's unfair because it's like, we don't get the same things that they get in the States up here in Canada. We do get some pretty great stuff. Again, don't get me wrong. I'm not complaining by any means. But I'm lucky enough that I live close enough to the border that we can go down and like get these things that not everyone else is, I guess, able to get. Because there are like the scalpers and the crazy people out there that will like buy this stuff and resell it online. But then there's also the really honest people as well that will like buy it and sell it to the people that don't have access to it in person, which is really nice. So kudos to you guys out there if you are like helping resell to the Halloween fans in the market without overcharging ridiculous prices for things. So anyways, now that that little spiel is over, we went to TJ Maxx. I got Scooby-Doo socks. These are super cute. $1.99. I couldn't say no. They had a few different styles, but I love those ones the best. Then next up here, I have this Joffrey's coffee, which we do carry up at the Winners and the HomeSense that we have. We carry the Joffrey's brand because I've seen like the Mickey and Minnie, like Halloween style coffee, but we didn't get the Hocus Pocus. I don't know why. Couldn't tell you. This is the Hocus Pocus coffee, and it is cinnamon, apple, and caramel. Sanderson Sisters brew. Flavor. This was $7.99. It smells great. I do get like the hints of like apple and caramel and stuff. And I don't typically like, I'm not a huge fan of coffee. Like I do like coffee. I love pumpkin spice, like steamed milk or pumpkin spice latte. But for Hocus Pocus, for the Sanderson Sisters, y'all know I had to get this and I'm glad that I found it. Then next up here is apparently like a really sought after piece, which I wasn't even aware of. Like I try and stay as connected to things online as I can in terms of like what's popular. Not that I like need to get the popular stuff, but just so I know like what people are looking for, so I know for myself, like, ooh, I may want that as well, you know what I mean? So I try and stay, like I said, as connected to the social media blogs and Twitter and Instagram and Facebook to see like what things are really popular, what things I may like, but I guess I wasn't as connected as I should be because I didn't know this blanket even existed. But when I saw it, I was like, oh, that's really cute, I like that a lot. And then Brandon was like, oh my god, that's like the blanket that everyone wants. And I was like, oh, okay, well, I just like it because I like the blanket. I don't like it for the fact that everyone else wants it. But I looked online then just to see, and I was just like, Halloween Ray Dunn blanket. And like the first thing that popped up on Google was like, I think it was Mercari or eBay or something, and somebody's selling it for like $150. And I was like, that's ridiculous. I need it. It's only $25. So anyways, it's this Ray Dunn Halloween blanket. It is so cute. Look at the ghost. He has legs. I'm obsessed. You got a jack-o'-lantern, you got a ghost with legs, you got floating ghost, you got Boo. I have no idea what the full thing looks like actually opened, because I obviously haven't opened it yet, but I'm really excited. It's a queen size throw as well, which is nice. It's 90 inches by 90 inches, so it's pretty big. It's big enough to fit on like a queen size bed with two people, which is great. It was $24.99. and I love it. I'm so excited to cuddle up with this. It's so cozy, so cute. I love any of like the classic kind of Halloween imagery, things like that. And I'm just very excited. I love a Halloween blanket. I have so many Halloween blankets already, and for whatever reason, we don't get them up here in Canada. Again, I couldn't tell you why. It's a blanket. Like, why do we not get that? It's so strange. And then going into those stores down in the States, it's like the aisles are filled with 30 different styles of Halloween blankets, and we don't get a single one. It's just so weird. I don't know why. But anyways, that's the stuff that I got at TJ Maxx. So let's continue on. The next store that we went to was Home Goods. And okay, so originally, if you watched the vlog, you may have seen at the TJ Maxx that we went to, I did find this beautiful Joanna Parker Halloween sugar and creamer set. And I was like, oh my God, this is so cute. I love the design. It's so like vintagey, classic Halloween. And I got it. It was $19.99. Bought it with the blanket, with the socks and the coffee. Then we went over like three stores down to the Home Goods, and we were shopping around, and I was filming my vlog, la-di-da, whatever. And I look on one of the shelves, and I was like, oh my God, they have the same Joanna Parker Halloween sugar creamer set. Like, let me just have a look at it and see. And I look, and the price tag was $7 cheaper than it was at the TJ Maxx. And I was like, what the heck? So the one from Home Goods was $12.99 for the creamer set. And then the one that I paid for at TJ Maxx was $19.99. And I looked closely at the sticker too, and I think I even said this in the vlog. And I was like, the sticker is like ripped in like part of it. Like, it almost looked as if somebody had like taken the sticker off and replaced it. Or like, I don't know. I don't know what people do, but like, it looks as if they maybe took the sticker off another item and put it back on to the coffee and creamer set to like get more money back than what they paid for it, if that makes sense. Even though they like didn't keep it because they returned it, it's like if they bought something that was $20 and bought something that was $13, they kept the $13 thing but like returned the creamer set at $20, if that makes sense. I don't know. Regardless, at Home Goods, I bought the one that was $12.99 and then went back to the TJ Maxx and returned that one there because I was like $7 US, like that's $12 Canadian kind of thing. It's like, I might as well get the exchange rate back for it if it's literally $12.99 three stores down. Like, it's all the same company that like puts all these things together and stuff. So I don't know. Like, that's my thought, was that maybe somebody switched the stickers or something. I don't know. But regardless, it all worked out. I got the one for $12.99, and here it is, this gorgeous Joanna Parker Halloween sugar and creamer set. So I'll just quickly open it and see. We don't get this stuff up here in Canada either. Like, for whatever reason, don't know, we don't get Joanna Parker Halloween. We don't get like some of the cutest stuff, which is again, so unfair, but I don't know why they do that to us. So here is the little sugar bowl. Oh my gosh, he's so cute. I love him. He looks like a little like pumpkin snowman kind of thing. I don't know, he's cute. And then the little owl creamer dish here, so you put your coffee cream in there and you got your little sugar bowl. It's so much fun. And for $12.99, honestly, even with the exchange rate, like, it's still under $20, which I feel like wouldn't even be that cheap here in Canada if we were to get it. So I'm very happy with this. I've never had a Joanna Parker piece before because, like I said, the past few years we haven't been down to the States around Halloween time, so I've never actually seen anything in person. I've seen it online, love it in other people's videos and photos and stuff, but now I finally have some of my own to enjoy, so we love that. Next up here, we have some larger scale items. Now, let me see. So we finished up over at Home Goods, and then we went to Bella's Fair Mall. We had some lunch at Panda Express. We walked around the mall, went to a few stores in there. I didn't actually get anything from any of the other stores. We went to like Bath & Body Works, Hot Topic, GameStop, Ulta and stuff, but I didn't get anything. And then we went into Target, and I was like, ooh, I'm stocking up at Target. So I have a few bags of things from Target now inside a Disney store bag. And again, just kind of picking from the bag, not doing anything more important than the other. But the first thing here, which I really do love, is this gorgeous little Hide and Eek Chihuahua skeleton. This was $15. If you guys don't follow me on social media, on my like Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, whatever social medias I have, which will all be linked down below, by the way, then you may not know that I have a little Chihuahua named Chanel. I got her earlier this year in April for my birthday, a little birthday treat to myself. I've always wanted a Chihuahua, and I finally got one this year, and I spoil her rotten. She's the most gorgeous little blonde-haired, blue-eyed Chihuahua. I love her so much. She is my pride and joy. She's my little girl, and I love anything Chihuahua. I've always loved anything Chihuahua my entire life. Like, ever since I was 6 years old, I wanted a Chihuahua, and now I finally have one, living my childhood dream. And anything Chihuahua, I always get. So when I saw this, I was like, I need that. Like, what the heck? It's so niche and specific and random, and it's perfect. And I'm obsessed. So here it is, the little Hide and Eek skeleton Chihuahua. I even curled her little tail to be just like Chanel's. It's so much fun. I will insert a clip here now so that you guys can watch Chanel's interaction with her meeting this little skeleton Chihuahua for the very first time, and let me know what you guys think.
Hi, baby. I got something to show you. Can you have a seat? Can you sit? Sit. Oh, good sit. Good girl. Look at this. This is you. Oh my gosh. Wow. It's just like you. Oh, do you love her? Chanel number two. You could be Chanel number one.
Wow.
Do you like her?
Yeah, she cute. Uh-huh.
Well, the kitties are coming to investigate. Rally the troops, they say. Oh, they're gonna fight. Okay, great.
What are they doing? I don't even know.
They're going crazy.
Do you like the little chihuahua skeleton? Is that pretty fun?
Yeah.
Okay, and that's what Chanel thought of the little chihuahua, so I think she loves her, honestly. This is Chanel number two, and my girl Chanel is Chanel number one, and they're so much fun. So I feel like I should just keep this out all year round because it's so, like I said, it's so niche and random that it's one of those things, like a chihuahua skeleton. Like, of all of the creatures that they could make, it's just so weird, but I love it. Next up here from Target, I got these Oots Ghost Puffs, white cheddar flavored puffs. I love the regular cheese puffs that they have, the little cheese balls. So good. I haven't tried the white cheddar ones before, and the fact that they're ghosts makes them even better, so can't wait to try those. I got these Pringles here, which are essentially just sour cream and onion Pringles, but they're in Halloween packaging, so they got me good. This is sour scream and onion, and it's a haunted house, spooky packaging all around. I love it so much. And then I got this little Pez candy dispenser of a bat, trick or treat. I couldn't remember if I had this one or not. I know I have the ghost for sure. They also have vampire, jack-o'-lantern, pumpkin, witch, the ghost, the bat. But I couldn't remember if I had the bat or not. And even if I do, at least I can like take this one out and use it and enjoy it. And it comes with candy corn flavored Pez candy, which I love, so can't wait for that. I think it was like $2 or something, so not bad at all. And then we get into all the pumpkin spice things, you guys. And yesterday for me was almost like a euphoric experience because we get like sprinklings of the pumpkin spice stuff up here in Canada, but nowhere near the amount that the States gets. Like, I remember a couple years ago when we got pumpkin spice Cheerios for the first time, and I was flabbergasted that we got them because it's one of those things, it's like, it's so simple, but it makes me so happy. And the fact that like we don't get it normally is just like, why? But we got some pumpkin spice things here in Canada. So again, I'm not complaining, I'm thankful for what we do have, but I'm also so thankful that I live close enough to the border that I can go down and stock up on everything pumpkin spice that the States makes, because they literally make everything in pumpkin spice flavor. It's absolutely wild. So you will see a lot of pumpkin spice flavored things throughout the video. So to start us out with pumpkin spice, we have the Nature's Path Organic Frosted Pumpkin Pie Flavored Toaster Pastry. So Pop-Tarts, essentially. Pumpkin pie Pop-Tarts. I'm obsessed. And they're like organic, healthy for you. I've actually done collaborations with Nature's Path here in Canada for Pride, for like drag events and stuff that I've done. They've sent me over PR boxes and stuff every Pride season for the past couple years to like make content and support them and everything, so I do. And trust me, if I could support them by always having frosted pumpkin pie Pop-Tarts in my life, I absolutely would. Like, I can't wait to try these out. Never had them before, but they sound so good, so I am very, very excited for those. And then next up here, we have some more Scooby-Doo graham crackers. This is like a big box of them, whereas those other little ones are like snack packs, so I can use those for lunches or something. And then next up in here, we have this Good and Gather, which I don't know the brand, but works for me. Pumpkin spice instant oatmeal. This is limited time only. This was the last one that was there on the shelf I saw, and I was like, snatch that, thank you so much. So there's 8 packets in here of the Good and Gather pumpkin spice oatmeal. Now, last year or the year before, we did have Quaker pumpkin spice oatmeal, but I haven't seen it yet this year. And I know that it's taken a bit of time for like some of our Halloween stuff to roll out, or like our pumpkin spice offerings to roll out, because we did just get the pumpkin spice Cheerios. I keep looking over there because they're over there on my counter. I can see them from here because I had a bowl earlier. We did just get those within the last like week or so, at least from what I've seen. So maybe we're still gonna be getting the Quaker pumpkin spice oatmeal, or maybe it's like a discontinued thing, or maybe it was just limited, I don't know. But regardless, I have this Good and Gather pumpkin spice oatmeal to try out now. So very excited for that. Then next up we have these 5 Spooky Halloween Designs Orange Colored Cream, same taste, Boo Oreos. So can't wait for these, delicious. Again, anything that has Halloween packaging or design or whatever, I have to get because I love it so much. Next up here, we have the Mrs. Myers, Clean Day Multi-Surface Everyday Cleaner Acorn Spice Scent. So for Mrs. Myers, we actually don't carry like all the fun special scents in stores, and I only know of like two stores that actually carry the Mrs. Meyers stuff. We don't have it everywhere like the States does, but I actually stock up online on Amazon because Amazon carries the apple cider scent. And I'm not sure if that's just like a limited thing for like stock or whatever, but I've gotten it repeatedly a few times. I think I've gotten like 3 orders of it or whatever. You have to order it in like packages of 2 and everything to make up for like the Amazon Prime delivery and everything, which is fine by me because I'd rather have more than not enough. So it's, I think it's like $5.99 a bottle for the spray or something on Amazon, but I've only ever seen the apple cider one online. I know there's a pumpkin spice one as well, but I didn't know that there was an acorn spice one. So when we were at Target and I saw this, I was like, let me smell that. And it smells so good. So that's why I decided to try out this one. If I see the pumpkin spice one next time I go down, I will definitely be snatching some of that up. But if I don't, at least I have this acorn spice, and then I can always continue to get my apple cider one on Amazon. And then next up here from Target, I have these little candies. These are just Jelly Belly Monster Mash. They were just in the Halloween candy section, and I thought they were really cute. They were like $1 a package. And they're just fun little like snack packs of Jelly Bellies. The flavors are caramel corn, green apple, Jewel grape soda, Jewel orange, and wild blackberry. Love those so much. Again, the Halloween package got me. He's dressed like a little vampire, I guess, leading you up to his haunted castle, which is great. So thank you, Mr. Jelly Belly, for the Monster Mash. And then the last thing in this bag from Target here is something that I've wanted for a bit, again, because we haven't been able to travel down to the States. I haven't been able to get these things, but now that the borders are open, I'm able to like stock up and actually treat myself to the things that I've wanted for years after seeing them online. This is the Hide and Eek Boutique 12-inch LED flickering jack-o'-lantern indoor light. Orange LED bulb, battery operated, flicker or steady effect. And it is so, so cute. I've seen this on like tons of people's Instagrams, YouTube videos, social medias. They have a few different designs of them as well, and I did film these in the vlog. There's a skull, there's a black cat, there's the jack-o'-lantern, there's a bat that they didn't have in stock because I would have gotten the bat with this one as well if they had it. This bat's my favorite animal, if you guys don't know. But I figured jack-o'-lantern, classic Halloween staple. Everyone loves a good jack-o'-lantern, and it's very, very cute. So I did put the batteries in last night to test it out when I got home and see. It's subtle. It's not something that's like super bright and intense, which is like, it's good and it's bad. It's definitely one of those like mood pieces that just kind of like ties a room together or like adds some ambiance and stuff, which I do love. So I can't wait to actually hang this up somewhere and display it. Love this piece so much, $15 at Target. Hopefully I'll have the bat when I go back in a couple weeks and I can get that one as well. Okay, now moving on with another bag here from Target. This one is an actual Halloween bag that I got from Walmart up here in Canada, I think a couple years ago, maybe last year. They had tons of cereals, you guys. Now, I mean tons. Along with the pumpkin spice Cheerios that we got last year, we got a Monster Mash cereal, which was like a mashup of Count Chocula, Frankenberry, and Booberry, I think it was, all like mixed in as one cereal. And then this year we just got Count Chocula, no Monster Mash, no Booberry, no Frankenberry. And I know we've had Frankenberry and Booberry cereals in the past because I did used to get them up here in Canada, but for whatever reason this year I've only seen the Count Chocula, the pumpkin spice Cheerios, and then the Reese's Puff Bats. So I got all 3 of those. But in the States, you guys, y'all have so many more crazy cereals that we don't have, and I'm so jealous of you, so I bought everything I had. The first one here that I see is the Shocking Orange Rice Krispies. This is the family size box, which is honestly just like a personal size for me, because I guess I could eat enough for a whole family, which makes sense. But they're just regular Rice Krispies, just colored orange, colored spooky fun Halloween orange. Love the packaging, love Snap, Crackle, and Pop in their little monster Halloween costumes. Love the design of the Rice Krispie treats there. Look at the back as well, this fun image. It's chaotic, it gives me like nostalgic early 2000s vibes. I just love it so much, like I'm obsessed. So can't wait to try that out, even though it just tastes like regular Rice Krispies, it's orange, so it's more fun. Then next up here, we have some of these ones. So this one here is Fruit Brute family size. It's artificially cherry flavored sweetened cereal with monster marshmallows. I've never actually tried this before. We've never had Fruit Brute in Canada. We've had, like I said, Frankenberry and Booberry and Count Chocula, but never Fruit Brute. So the cherry flavor to me sounds very interesting. So I am excited for that. Then next up here is Frankenberry, which like I said, I've tried before. And this is strawberry flavored cereal with monster marshmallows, and love little Frankenberry, so much fun. The next one here is Booberry, which is artificially berry flavored monster cereal with monster marshmallows. Super duper cute, little ghosts and blue marshmallows. I feel like, if I remember correctly, I love the Booberry one the most. So if I do eat these throughout the next couple weeks, I will stock up on whichever is my favorite if they have them there on the 30th. Then here we have the family size guys, Kellogg's Special K Pumpkin Spice. Oh my gosh, I can't wait for this. It's really funny, actually, when we were shopping in the States last night, we were going up and down all the aisles, and I mean, like me, there's lots of Canadians that do go down there and stock up on the things that we don't have up here in Canada. And I had this in my buggy, and this woman and her mother were going past us, and they said something like, ooh, Pumpkin Spice Special K, where'd you get that? And I was like, oh, down like the cereal aisle. It wasn't on an end cap, it was just like mixed in with all the other cereals. They were like, oh, we have to go get some of that. And I looked in their buggy, and their whole buggy was also everything pumpkin spice, which is honestly kind of iconic. So I salute them, I love them. We had a few laughs throughout the store because we kept running into each other. And then they also went to Trader Joe's as well to stock up on things there, which we also did. And we ended up seeing them there too. It was just funny. So anyways, we love the pumpkin spice stuff, obviously, as Canadians, we don't get enough. And then the last cereal that I got there from Target was the family size limited edition Captain Crunch's Halloween Crunch. I feel like I've heard of this before. Not sure if it was ever like a fever dream or what the situation was, but regardless, it's Halloween Crunch, you guys. There's ghost cereal pieces that turn the milk green, apparently, which sounds so unique. I guess they have like little green flecks on them or green dye or whatever it is, I don't know. But it just sounds so good, so ridiculous, and I can't wait. It's honestly so exciting. Again, the packaging is just so nostalgic looking for me. I've never had this before, but I just feel like I know this. You know what I mean? It's just a good feeling. So can't wait to try all of these cereals. And like I said, when I go back there in a couple weeks, I will definitely stock up on whichever ones I love the most. And also, this was the last box that was there on the shelf of the Captain Crunch Halloween Crunch. And they were doing a special where it was like buy one box, get one 25% off, I think. So I actually didn't do that in like the right order. Did I? One, two, three. Oh, I did that. We're good. Never mind. Okay, now moving on to some more fun stuff from Target that isn't just cereal and food. I have this bag here from Zootopia filled with just the one thing in here, actually. I think it's just the one thing, but still a really cool piece. This is the Hide and Eek. What is it called? Lit Tombstone, battery operated lit tombstone. This was $20. I saw this on the shelf and I was like, that is the cutest thing ever. So much fun. Let's light him up and see if you guys can see. Okay, yeah, you can see he gets like more intensely orange. The rip lights up as well. It's just so much fun. It's like a blow mold style design. It's super cute. For $20, I couldn't pass it up, honestly. It's very heavy as well. Like, it's obviously weighted down in the bottom to be, is it indoor, outdoor? Indoor, outdoor, yeah. Indoor, outdoor, decorative use only, not a toy. So this can go outside, which is awesome. And I can't wait to have this as one of the staple Halloween decorations on my front porch this year. It is so cute. And like I said, for $20, I couldn't pass it up. If they had more, I probably would have gotten two, just because I feel like a pair of them on like either side of the fence or something like that would be so cute, but they only have the one. Maybe when we go back in a couple weeks, they might have another one and I can pick another guy up then, but even to just have the one is so awesome. I love it so much. Okay, and I think the last couple things here from Target, as far as what I can tell, yeah, the last few things here are more food items. So we're ending with more food from Target. I saw these pumpkin spice bagels down like the bread aisle, and they were just literally hidden on like a bottom shelf. And we were just walking by and I saw like the orange on the side and I was like, pumpkin? Oh my gosh, I have to get them. What are they? Pumpkin spice bagels. They're from a brand called Thomas, which we don't have up here in Canada, don't know it. But they're limited edition pumpkin spice bagels, naturally and artificially flavored. Start your morning with Thomas's pumpkin spice bagels. And I'd love to. And they will pair perfectly with something that I picked up from Trader Joe's, which I'm sure you guys can use your imagination to figure it out. But I can't wait to try these out. They sound so delicious, so love those. And then I got this Danone, which I'm pretty sure we have up here in Canada. Like, we have Danone yogurt, but we don't have pumpkin spice yogurt. This is a Greek pumpkin pie light and fit yogurt. It looks delicious. It was in one of their like cooler end caps there at like one of the refrigerated aisles, and I saw it and I was like, heck yes, give me that Hello Autumn pumpkin pie yogurt. Look at the little scarecrow there. He ain't scaring me. He's enticing me to spend money on yogurt that tastes like pumpkin pie, and I love that. So that's great. And then next up from Target here, you guys, I think, okay, if you watch the vlog, you will see me, I think, let out audible gasps, if I can recall correctly. I'll have to look back at that footage and see, because I remember being like, oh my God, that's insane. I got some of the things that I love the most about America. If you guys don't know, in October 2018, and then September, October 2018, I went to New Orleans with my mom, and I love New Orleans. I love everything about New Orleans. I love the history, just everything about New Orleans, the culture that it has, and I'm just so obsessed with it. And I was so lucky to be able to visit New Orleans back in 2018. with my mom. We had the most amazing time. We went for 10 days. Princess and the Frog is my favorite Disney movie, in case you guys aren't aware, and it's set in New Orleans. And I just lived my Princess and the Frog spooky American Horror Story coven fantasy when we were there. So anytime that I have like certain memories or things about that, it just takes me back to such a special place and time in my life. And this next item is definitely something that takes me back there. And I had these for the first time when I was in New Orleans. And I was actually able to pick them up at Walmart in the States, down in Bellingham, where we always go, numerous times in the past. That anytime we had gone, it'd been like, oh my god, they have these, they have these, they have these, I have to stock up. And I would always get like 5 or 6 bags of these at a time. And then the last time that we were there, back in, I think, May or July, because we did go twice earlier this year, they didn't have them. And then the second time we went, they didn't have them. And I was like, what's going on? That's really strange for them to not have them. Like, this was something that wasn't a limited edition item there on their shelves. Like, they were a permanent fixture in their shelves, and they just disappeared from their shelves. So I'm not sure if I was like the only person buying them, or if they just like cut ties with the supplier, or what the situation was. But when I was at Target shopping down the Halloween candy section, filming my vlog, like, ooh, look at all the fun Halloween candy, I panned down to the bottom shelf and I found these, and I died. I was so excited. These are the Zapp's Voodoo Chips. This is like a Halloween snack bag, so it's 18 mini bags, but like I said, from Walmart, I would get like the large, normal size bags. But to see them just again in person was, it was a mind bent, like it was insane. I had such a great time finding these, you guys. I was so, so, so excited. They are probably one of my favorite potato chips, if not my favorite potato chip. There's nothing like, okay, there is. I was gonna say, there's nothing like exceedingly special about them. They're just the best chip, just believe me. If you guys haven't tried these before or don't know these, they're a New Orleans style kettle chip. I'm pretty sure they're like based from New Orleans. Like, yeah, New Orleans kettle chips are cooked to perfection and combined with premium ingredients. The special recipe results in a crunchier, tastier, unique potato chip experience, which we hope you'll prefer. The folks at Zapp's Potato Chips, thank you. Enjoy great tasting potato chips anywhere in the USA, and apparently not at Walmart in Bellingham because they don't have them anymore. But these are the Voodoo flavor, and I remember when we were in New Orleans, there was like this little hole in the wall corner store market kind of thing that we went into that like had the best sandwiches that I saw on like Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives or something like that. I saw it on some website or TV show or something that was like, you need to go here if you want like authentic New Orleans style sandwiches. So we went in there and I saw these chips on the shelf and I was like, oh, that sounds fun. Voodoo, we're in like the land of voodoo. Let's try out these potato chips. And I was shocked. I thought they were gonna be like spicy, hot, like burn your mouth flavor, but they're essentially just all dressed. So if you guys live in the States, and I'm pretty sure you don't have all dressed chips, this is like your alternative to all dressed, because up here in Canada, that's one of our like signature flavors. We have like ketchup and all dressed, which like nowhere else has apparently. So this is essentially just like an all dressed flavored potato chip, but they are so, so, so good. And I think just like the theming and like the memory that I have behind it and the connotation with like visiting New Orleans and everything, it's just such a special chip to me. So like I said, not seeing them at Walmart the past few times I've been there has been such a disappointing experience, because they're something that I would stock up on to like relive that memory. If you guys have that kind of like mindset where certain like flavors or scents or things like that trigger you or like take you back to certain situations, let me know down in the comment section, because I'm pretty sure I'm not crazy. Like, I'm pretty sure that's a thing. And it just makes me feel so like special to know that like this flavor, like me eating this potato chip, takes me back to like October 1st, 2018 in New Orleans, when I was sitting there in Jackson Square eating these potato chips with my mom. Like, it's just such a weird like sensory experience. So I stocked up on 3 bags of these Voodoo chips, you guys. 3 bags of 18 bags of potato chips. So there's 1, there's 2, and there's 3. It's great. I love it. And I will probably be getting more in a few weeks when I go back, just because of the fact that I haven't seen the big bags at Walmart or Target anymore. So I don't know if they're just a special limited Halloween thing that they're doing now. Like, this bag here says Halloween snack packs, so like obviously they're meant for like trick-or-treating, handing out on Halloween night. But I couldn't believe it. To see them again was just such a special thing. So that's why I stocked up and bought so many. And it's only like $7.99 for 18 bags. Like, I couldn't go wrong with it. So that's why I stocked up on them, and they're delicious. So if you guys haven't tried these before and you've seen them on your shelves and been like, oh, those sound kind of neat, buy them, try them. Let me know what your guys' thoughts are. Or if you have had these before, these New Orleans Zapp Voodoo style chips, let me know what your guys' thoughts are, because I love them so, so much. I know they make other flavors of these chips as well, because I did try their ones when I was in New Orleans. This is just like the Voodoo flavor of them. But they have other flavors of the potato chips as well. So let me know what you guys think of them because I love them so, so much. They're so good. And now that I've talked for 20 minutes about potato chips, let's move on to the next store and see what else I got. Okay, the next bag that I have here is from Marshall's. And I actually bought this bag while we were there at Marshall's because I thought I brought enough reusable bags, but after our little shopping experience that we had at Target, I was like, oh no, I didn't bring enough bags. So I bought this cute bag and it's honestly adorable. It was 99 cents. I couldn't go wrong with it. I just love the imagery again. It's kind of like vintagey, classic. You got a little skeleton, a little owl, a little ghost, a little black cat, all wearing costumes and holding lanterns and stuff. Very fun. Thought it was very cute. So the first thing in here that I got, I can show you guys, is this adorable little sweater that I got for my girl Chanel. It says boo. It's a little extra small dog sweater or pet sweater, I guess. You could put your cats in this too if you want. And it's knitted. It says boo in orange, yellow, pink, and green. And it has black and orange design on it. It's just so much fun. I love the collar. I'll insert a clip here of Chanel wearing it or a photo or whatever is gonna be here just so you guys can see how she looks in it. It is so, so cute. We saw this and I was like, I can't say no. Like, she loves sweaters. And I put it on her last night and she fell asleep in it and slept through the whole night with it on. So I think she loves it. Like, I had to take it off of her to film this video. So I honestly think she loves this sweater so much, which I'm so happy about because I'd be a lot more disappointed if she didn't like the sweater. And then next up here from Marshall's, I got this shirt, which was the only clothing piece that I actually bought yesterday while we were there, which is fine because I was going mostly for Halloween stuff, but I found a Halloween shirt, you guys, and it is so cute. It's Boo Crew from Denim and Flower, Ricky Singh. I don't know the designer or the creation, but apparently the MSRP price is $44, which I would never pay $44 for this shirt anyways. But I got it for $12.99 at Marshall's, so I couldn't say no to that. It's just a cute button-up with, I don't know if you guys can tell, there is bats on it, there's jack-o'-lanterns with various faces, there's like a skeleton-looking jack-o'-lantern, one, is he smoking a cigar or something, or what is he doing? Oh, he has a tongue, he has his tongue out, there's one with a knife through his mouth, there's one with like a witch hat and a scythe, lots of cute different designs of jack-o'-lanterns, and then the bats all over it, and I love it. So, like I said, for 13 bucks, I couldn't say no. In the vlog, I like showed how it looked on, and I think with like either a plain black or like a plain white button-up on underneath, it could be super cute, or just buttoned up all the way as well. It's just a nice shirt to have, so. And then lastly here from Marshall's, I got this, and this piece is to go with the creamer and sugar set that I got earlier. This is another design from Joanna Parker. It is the Pumpkin Peep mugs. These are so cute. They're huge. They're massive. When I saw these on the shelf, I was like, holy cannoli, those are literally bigger than the creamer container and the sugar container, and they're mugs. So these were $12.99 at Marshall's, and I love them. They're so much fun. I have to show you guys these because I showed you the other Joanna Parker pieces. So let's have a look at these. There's this little one here, which is a devil, and he is so adorable. I love this so much. They're huge inside, like I said, they're massive mugs. And then there's this little spider guy. I couldn't tell what he was from inside the package. I was like, what is that? And then I was like, wait, he has two handles there. And then I looked at the back and I was like, oh, he's a spider, those are little legs. So he's like, yeah, he's just a cute little spider. I was gonna say he's like on a pumpkin or something, but that wouldn't make sense because this is obviously his body, but his other legs are just hanging out around the back here. It's just so cute. I love it so much. Again, huge inside. $12 for these. I couldn't say no. And I figured that I got the coffee creamer and the sugar bowl set. I might as well just get the mugs to go with it as well. So I did. And that was everything that I got from Marshall's. And now we're gonna move on to more. Okay, next up here, I don't have a bag for this stuff, so I'm just gonna keep it there as a surprise. We went to Ross, and I don't think I've ever been to a Ross before. And it was honestly, it was chaotic. It was hectic. We went in there. It was one of the last stops of the night, and I didn't know what to expect. And it was a lot, you guys. Like, it had been so picked over. It was still like filled with stuff, but it had been so picked over to the point that it was like messy and unorganized. I got like, and this is no disrespect to Ross, so if anyone that loves Ross is watching, it's no shade. Like, I loved it. It was really cute and cool. But it gave me like thrift store vibes. Like, I walked in and I was like, oh, it's kind of like Value Village. But then I realized like, it's not, because it's all like new stuff. Like, it's new things that haven't been worn or used and eaten or whatever. But it just gave me like Value Village vibes in terms of like the cleanliness and organization. So I'm not sure if it was just a bad location or if all the Ross stores are like that, but either way, like, it was unique. It was definitely a unique experience to visit my first Ross, and that's what it was like. It was also close to closing time, so like maybe it was just so busy throughout the day they didn't have time to organize it or clean it. Plus it was a Saturday, so I mean, that could very well be the case. But regardless, it was definitely a unique experience. Next up here from Ross, I picked up to go with my mugs and my coffee creamer and sugar set. This is the Joanna Parker salt and pepper shakers. And these are so adorable. The little like black cats, like the vintage classic looking black cat with a little like scarf neck piece and a little hat. They are so cute. I love them so much. And these were $5.99. And they're just so adorable. I had to get them. I don't know if I'll ever use them as salt and pepper shakers. Like, I do have other salt and pepper shakers for Halloween time that I don't actually use as salt and pepper shakers. I just use them as, like, decor pieces. So these may just become, like, all year round focal pieces for my kitchen, or they'll be useful. I don't know. Either way, I had to get them. They're so cute. And they fit with everything else that I got Joanna Parker for this day. So it was definitely, like, a Joanna Parker style day for me, stocking up on things from the brand that I've never had anything from before. So we're good with Joanna Parker now. Next up here, I have this, what even is this? The Witching Hour Flatware Caddy with swivel base, wipe clean with a damp cloth. This is just a like utensil caddy thing. It says, welcome to our coven, which I love so much. And it is sectioned off in here as well. So we do have like a utensil caddy on the counter right now that has all of our utensils, like whisk, spatula, flippers, those kinds of things, but it's a lot smaller than the things that we have in there. So like things will get lodged in there and you have to like pull out a bunch of stuff to get one thing out. So when I saw that this was bigger and it's also sectioned off, I was like, that's perfect. I need it. Plus it swivels so you can like spin it around if you want to. So I love it. And it was $7.99 and it's just so cute. I had to get it and I feel like it'll go perfectly with all the other fun, spooky, Halloween-y things that we have in our kitchen. So can't wait to put that to good use. Okay, you guys, and then our last store of the night last night before we went to Jack in the Box and stocked up on delicious food there at Jack in the Box, we went to Walmart. And I bought a lot of goodies there at Walmart. So let's dig into this bag. This is a trick-or-treat reusable shopping bag or Halloween candy trick-or-treat bag, if you will. And let's see what we got from Walmart. So I got these Cheetos Bag of Bones here. These are the cinnamon sugar flavored ones. I've never had these before. We do get the like original white cheddar flavored ones up here in Canada, but never seen cinnamon sugar before. So when I saw these, I was like, I have to try those. I love anything dusted and like cinnamon sugar. So like churros or anything else like that, I love. So I have high hopes for these. Can't wait to try those out. And then next up here in the bag, we have the Great Value, which is just like the Walmart home brand, pumpkin spice marshmallows, and they're shaped like little pumpkins and fall leaves. I think these were like 98 cents, so I had to say yes to these. There's even a recipe on the back for spooky jack-o'-lantern dipped marshmallows. So if you guys are interested in that, you can have a look there and see all the information about that. But I figured these would be really good for the pumpkin spice hot chocolate that I've been making lately. Might as well throw in some more pumpkin spice flavored things in there to the mix and see how they taste. Next up here in the bag, we have these limited edition flips. Pumpkin spice covered pretzels. Never tried these before. Didn't even know what these were. Never heard of this brand, but they sound very unique and very delicious. Again, I love anything pumpkin spice. So to have a pretzel covered in pumpkin spice would, I'm sure, be absolutely delicious. Then we have these Peeps, marshmallow pumpkins and marshmallow ghosts. We don't have these up here in Canada, so I had to get these down in the States. I think they were like a dollar each as well. There's three pumpkins and three ghosts. The one thing for Peeps that I have seen up here in Canada is at either Winners or Marshalls or HomeSense or whatever one it is. It's like a little pumpkin spice hot chocolate set. It comes with a mug, a package of this, and I think like a package of hot chocolate powder, and it's like $15 or something for it. And I was like, that seems like ridiculously overpriced if I just wanted to try the Peeps. I know they're just like marshmallow flavor, like they're not pumpkin spice at all. They're just marshmallow flavored Peeps, but still, for the theming and the pumpkin effect, again, they got me. Next up here, we have some candies. I'm just gonna pull out all the candies and show you guys quickly because I did get a few different options for me to try. I got the Twix Ghosts. We don't have these up here in Canada. I'm pretty sure they're just regular Twix, but in the shape of ghosts. So again, they got me there, had to try those. I got these jack-o'-lantern Snickers. No idea how these are gonna look like a jack-o'-lantern, but again, we don't have these in Canada. Couldn't tell you why. Then I got the Brax Caramel Apple Candy Corn. So similar to what the regular candy corn is, but I'm assuming just caramel apple flavor, which sounds delicious. Then these I got that sound like so much fun. They are Shriekers Skittles. Beware, try if you dare. And this is the share size package. And it says some are so sour that they will make you shriek. So I guess that they're like all mixed in together and you just have to take a risk and see which ones are so sour and which ones aren't. There's rattled raspberry, ghoulish green apple, citrus scream, shocking lime, and spine tingling tangerine. So I think that there's like, of those five flavors, there's some that are sour versions and some that are regular versions, I guess, because there's not like repeats of the colors, so it wouldn't be done that way. I think it's just like various versions of the same flavor, which is kind of cool. I know they've had like the spicy Skittles before, which have like hot ones mixed in there as well, which is a very unique concept, but I've never tried the Halloween Shriekers, so can't wait to try those. Love all the Halloween candy that I can get. Next up here, I have this bag of marshmallows, and this is just ghost marshmallows. These aren't flavored like anything. I don't, maybe they're ghost flavor. I don't even know what that tastes like, but they're just cute little ghost marshmallows. And there's a recipe on here as well for haunted dipped goats. For goats, oh no, can you imagine? There's a recipe on here for haunting dipped ghosts, not goats. That would be too weird. But yeah, very cute, love those. I think they were like a dollar again, so might as well try them. Then I have these little hand soaps. There is Dreary Dracula and Wacky Witch. These are by Soft Soap. The Dracula is pumpkin spice scent and the Witch is berry scented. And they were like two for $2, so a dollar each for these Halloween soaps. I figured, why not get some soap? I love Halloween hand soaps and I love having soap all year round that's spooky, so that makes me happy. Then I have this Great Value brand candy corn flavored syrup. I love that it says candy corn flavored syrup artificially flavored. They couldn't just say like candy corn artificially flavored syrup. I don't know, but either way, I don't know, like candy corn, honestly, like isn't candy corn just made from honey? Like to me, candy corn just tastes like sweet. It's just like honey sweetness kind of thing. So for them to have, oh my gosh, is that glitter? What the heck? Sorry, I just got distracted, you guys, because I did not realize, if you look in the bottom there, it's literally like glitter in the bottom of this bottle of candy corn. That's so unique. I wonder if it has to be like shaken up in order to incorporate that all. Edible glitter candy corn syrup, that's honestly a serve. But either way, what is this gonna taste like? Because candy corn is just sweet, so it's just gonna be like sweet sugary syrup, which is fun. I love that to go with my pumpkin spice waffles and everything that I got. Might as well have this, but I think I have to keep it like this so that that edible glitter or whatever that is will mix around the rest of the bottle. Didn't even notice that yesterday. That's really cool. Next up in here, we have these Krispy Kreme brand mini crullers pumpkin spice flavor for a limited time only. Brandon seems to think we've had these before. I don't think we've ever had these before because we haven't been down to the States around Halloween time together, so I don't know when we've gotten these. Maybe we've tried them before in the past, but I don't even think that our single Krispy Kreme store we have up here in Canada or here in BC has pumpkin spice flavored donuts at Halloween time. I could be wrong, but I don't think they do. So can't wait to try these though. Again, another pumpkin spice thing to add to the list to try. It's gonna be great. Next up here from Walmart, I got this little set of Halloween window clings. They're just so cute. They're like almost vintagey style. I was saying this in the vlog. I was like, they look vintagey. They also look like handmade kind of thing, which I like. So they were $1.24. I couldn't say no to them. And in thinking to that, our like two Walmarts that I have close to us didn't have like anything Halloween. It's so weird. Like they have Christmas stuff out now, but throughout the past like 2 months that the Halloween stuff, or month and a half, I guess, that Halloween stuff has been out, they had like two things and now it's gone and they're like putting Christmas out. So I'm not sure what happened along the way because Halloween just doesn't come and go that instantly with the stuff. Like it's just so weird. But regardless, they didn't have any of the stuff that I have gotten at the stores here in Canada. So, but I was just thinking about that. Like we didn't have any Halloween here in Canada for Walmart. So weird. Then next up here, I have the Pillsbury Funfetti Cake Mix with Candy Bits. It's just Funfetti Cake Mix, but they're like spooky Halloween colors. It's like orange, black, and purple. So love that. I love a good Funfetti Cake Mix. And then to go with that, I got the Pillsbury Funfetti Midnight Black Frosting with little ghosts and green and orange and white polka dot sprinkles. Super interesting. Black frosting just sounds like so much fun. Stain your teeth black. Look like your teeth are rotting out of your face for Halloween. It's wonderful. I love that. And then lastly from Walmart here, I have this Great Value pumpkin spice naturally and artificially flavored chai latte mix. You guys, this just sounded so good to me. I love pumpkin spice. I love chai tea lattes. Put them both together and you have a delicious combination of a drink and I can't wait to try it. So I don't know how this is. What is it? You serve, mix a quarter cup of chai latte mix with hot water, stir and enjoy. That's it. And then you could take some of the pumpkin spice marshmallows and put them in there and have a deliciously sweet treat of a chai latte and then dip some Halloween cookies or something in it. It'd be so good. Look at me making up recipes here on the spot. I love that. And then actually the last thing from Walmart, which I pulled out of the fridge and put here on the table and I just saw now, is the Mountain Dew Mystery Flavor Voodoo for 2022. Now, when we were at Walmart, we walked into Walmart, and right there at the front of Walmart, they had the big cases of the Voodoo. And I was like, yes, grab that, put it in the cart. It was like $7 for it, which is honestly kind of pricey because that's like the same price as what Soda Pop is here in Canada. But I was like, it's limited edition, it's Halloween, it's Voodoo, let's get it. But then I saw the small bottles and I was like, okay, let me just try out a small bottle to taste it and see if I like it before I like indulge in spending the like $12 it will be for this one case of soda if I don't even love it. So my friend John tried it. I'm pretty sure he said it was like grapefruity, if I can remember correctly as to what he said. Not 100% certain, but like if so, I do get grapefruit vibes from it just based on like the packaging and the color. I know there's like, I think it's a Fanta that's grapefruit flavored, or maybe it's like an Orangina that's like grapefruit flavored. And it has like the same kind of like foggy, kind of clear white color. So maybe that's like the vibe that they're going with. I guess I could like look it up and see what it is if they've released it. I think they release it like a month later or whatever after Halloween, or just see what people's theories are with the flavor. But also there on the bottle, you can see that it's number 4, which I think corresponds to the 4th flavor of this that they've done. I do have cans of the Voodoo from last year. I have one opened and like drank, and then one brand new like sealed can that we got last year. I don't even think I tried the Voodoo flavor from last year. I think Brandon opened and drank his, and mine's the one that's still sealed, so I can't remember what last year's flavor even tasted like if I tried to. But for you guys on camera right now, my special viewers, I'm gonna open up the 2022 limited edition flavor Mystery Voodoo and let you guys know what I think. I'm gonna try it right here on camera. So let's see. I'll do like a full, ooh, jeez. A full theory review for you guys. So, oh, what is the smell? I know this smell. It almost smells like a rocket popsicle. Like, you know, rockets, like the three, like yellow, blue, red. It smells kind of like that, but also like citrusy. I mean, there is lemon in the rocket pops. So maybe that's it. Okay, let me try. Let's see. Okay, here we go. That made my whole tongue go like crazy sour right there. What is the flavor? I have no idea. I honestly don't know. I feel like maybe I'm not crazy. It tastes kind of like rocket pops or maybe grapefruit, like my friend John said, if that's what he said. Either way, it's great. I would definitely buy a case of this, like the full 12 pack of the cans. So maybe when I go on the 30th, I can get that. Yeah, it's unique. I like it. I don't know what it is, but again, that's the joy of the mystery. Maybe after Halloween, they'll let us know what the flavor was, and that way we can stop theorizing, but I will definitely have to go into Google after this and see what those theories are for that flavor, because I have no idea what it tastes like. It's good, though, so I like it. Thank you, Mountain Dew. Thank you, Voodoo. Okay, and now with that, that is the last item for this haul video. Now, I did go to Trader Joe's, and I did spend a crazy amount of money at Trader Joe's on the pumpkin spice stuff there. I think I bought every single pumpkin spice item that Trader Joe's has to sell. And even the cashier when we were paying, he was like, everything in your buggy is orange, which was true because it was all pumpkin spice and it's great. But I'm not going to include those haul items in this video here. You guys will just have to wait and see a full Trader Joe's pumpkin spice haul and taste test video that I'm so excited to film. A lot of the stuff does also have to be like prepared or like served with something else in order to enjoy it to like the best of his ability, because I'm not just gonna like eat salsa out of a jar just like that, or like eat a thing of cream cheese. That'd be kind of weird. But I do have some things to like pair it with now, and that's gonna be a fun separate video. Maybe I'll film that tomorrow, and I don't know when that'll be uploaded and posted, but still, this is what I'm just thinking about. So if you guys are watching this right now, definitely make sure you stay tuned for my Trader Joe's pumpkin spice haul and taste test video, because that's gonna be a lot of fun. And for all of those things, I've not tried any of it before, because I've never had any of the Trader Joe's pumpkin spice stuff in my life. So everything is gonna be brand new and exciting to me, which I cannot wait for. So it's gonna be a good time. But that is it for this video. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you stuck around and watched to the very end of this, thank you so much from the bottom of my spooky heart. I really appreciate it. I hope you had so much fun watching. and as much fun as I enjoyed filming it for you. Let me know what your guys' thoughts are. What do you think of today's haul? Do you like it? Is there things that you already have or things that you're on the hunt for that you're looking out for? Let me know what your guys' thoughts are and leave me a comment down in the comment section below. We can chat down there about all of our favorite things. Do you already have some of these items? What things are you on the hunt for? Which of these items is your favorite thing? I would just love to know. I'd love to chat with you guys. So comment down below and we can chit chat down there. Also Instagram me, send me photos of things that you guys have seen out in the wild or things that you've collected already. Because I'd love to know what everyone else is up to and what everyone else is collecting. And then I can also go and hunt for those things that I don't need but I want. So yes, that is it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to click on that subscribe button wherever it's around me and hit that notification bell as well to be notified every time that I upload a new spooky video here on YouTube. And comment down below, like I said, we can chat down there and talk about all things spooky, scary, skeleton-y, and Halloween-y down there. And that is it for this video. All my social media links will be down in the Morpho box as well, including my Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, my TikTok, which has been popping off lately. So definitely make sure you guys go check out those links. And until next time, I will see you all very soon. Thank you for watching and have a spooky good time wherever you are. Bye.